So I would like to talk with you, or at least I got the task to talk with you about food allergens, especially on strategies to reduce the risk and consequences of food allergy. And I use apple as model crop. First, a short introduction to allergies. So many people, when they say I work on allergy in apple, they are surprised that allergy exists. They even say, I've never heard about it, it could not be true, and so on. But it is true. Although fruit is generally considered as very healthy, an apple a day keeps the doctor away, some people suffer from fruit allergy. And for apple, about 4% of the Northwest European population is allergic. And that number is not that high, but it is 70% of the people that suffer from hay fever. And if you are allergic to apple, you usually are also allergic to other type of fruit. So I have colleagues in my business unit that don't eat any apple, any cherries, any rosacea product. And what are the risks and consequences? The risks depends on the symptoms you have. There are two types of symptoms. You have the oral allergy syndrome, and you have systematic responses. And luckily, most people suffer from the oral allergy syndrome. And that is just inconvenient for 5 minutes up to several days. Some people, when they take a bite for 2 days, they are constantly like that, can't sleep, and become crazy of that, but just become crazy for 2 days and then it's over. I say just, not to say it's not serious, but compared to the other one, which is lethal, you can have a shock and die from it. Luckily, that the prevalence of that is very, very low, and mainly occurs in Mediterranean countries. So when I talk here with you, it's about the oral allergy syndrome, which is inconvenient, itching, swelling of the throat, sometimes so severely that you think you can't breathe anymore. So people sometimes panic, but you can say from a medical point of view, so what? That's how people react, and you laugh about it, but yeah, if you are, of course, if you are one of those persons, you are not happy with that, not understanding of the impact on your life. And the strategy all people follow is usually avoidance, avoidance of consumption. And according to Isofood dogma, that affects health, and of course also in real life, you need a fruit, and also have an impact on the feeling of well-being. Allergy-friendly cultivars, do they exist? Yes. Because apple cultivars differ in their allergenicity. Several are highly allergenic, and some are allergy-friendly. For instance, the cultivar Santana. 50% of the people that are allergic to apple can eat Santana without any symptom. 25% have some symptoms, but they are so happy they can eat, they ignore, and they just continue. 25%, the symptoms are so severe that they don't like the apple at all and just leave it. So, allergy-friendly cultivars exist and can be fine, can be helpful to many, but not to all. And we have to be aware of that, because it has a great impact on the availability of this type of cultivars. I explain with the next one of the next slides. So strategies to reduce the risk and consequences could be to market allergy-friendly cultivars as such. Inform the public about a lot of facts. Identify existing allergy-friendly cultivars. Personalize diagnosis. Apply allergy-friendly production practices. Or create new allergenic cultivars. And those topics I will go along with you during the next few slides. Marketing. As an allergy-friendly apple is not helpful to everybody, it is not an easy message. Because you cannot make an advertisement, this is hypoallergenic, you can eat it. Allergy apple, apple allergy sufferer, eat his apple and you have no problem. You can't sell it like that. If you give that impression, you can expect a lot of claims. So people from the television, from big shops, are cautious in taking this product as such in the market, in the bus, in the shop. And so you have to make a very clear message. And to do that, Santana is marketed with a leaflet. It describes a test protocol. It describes how, if you would, for the first time would be that you are going to eat a Santana apple, you have to test yourself. Take a bite, wait 15 minutes, take two more bites, wait 15 minutes, and so on, but until you have consumed the entire apple. And for the next occasion, you can eat directly. Also, the apples are wrapped. That is to avoid mix-up with other cultivars. If you think you buy an apple, but there's some apples from the other basket coming in, then, well, if you are not aware, it looks similar, and you don't look so closely how an apple looks like, you can be mistaken and have strong responses. So it took quite a number of years to get this system going, to get retailers willing to sell the apple, but now for 2 years in the Netherlands, there are two retailers, Albert Heijn, which is the largest supermarket in the Netherlands, and the C1000, which is second, they are selling it. So inform the public, and I think Agri-Food is going to do a good job on that. And you are not, probably don't know yet, but Maybrit Anderson and Sharon Hall, who are here in the audience, they are preparing, they are in the final stages of preparing a website for Agri-Food to inform people about food allergy and perhaps how you can avoid the consequences and can eat some food. It's just increasing availability to people in a way and thereby food consumption. Another strategy could be identify existing allergy-friendly cultivars. And we can use still some more. Why? Because Santana is not good for everyone. So you need other apples for people that cannot eat Santana but can eat another apple. But also we need other cultivars for extended availability because Santana can be stored till March. So thereafter there's nothing. While a Golden Delicious can be stored the entire year through. So if you cultivar like that, then there will be more availability and thereby more consumption. And then for a different taste, it could be that there's an apple that gives not any response to you, but you don't like the taste. It just happens in life. I myself are fairly narrow-minded. I like Alstar, and then I like Alstar, and then I like Alstar. So if there's no Alstar, I don't eat any yet. And if you're like me, then there's probably nothing to eat.